Hello, and welcome to ASL Basics with Miss Colleen. I recommend this program for children ages 6 and up. However, you're never too early or too late to start learning a new language. Let's go ahead and stretch out our hands just a little bit. Remember, you don't want them to hurt. You just want to loosen up your fingers and your wrists a little bit. Go ahead and give them a shake. Rub them together if they're a little bit cold. Make sure they're nice and warm. And we are going to go ahead and start part two of animals. Now, if you missed part one, you can go back to the videos list or back to the playlist and find it there. To start part two, we are going to cover some bugs, some common bugs that might sometimes get in your house, but most of the time they stay outside, right? The sign for bug is we're going to take the number three, place our thumb on our nose, and just kind of curl our middle and index finger in. Bug. 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 One bug that is very common, that gets in our house all the time, right, is the fly, and it buzzes around and drives us crazy, right? So, fly is a very short word. You can pretty much just spell it F-L-Y. Fly. But if you're talking about the fly that was buzzing around your head and keeping you awake last night, take an F and just let it fly, kind of meander all over the place. It's really annoying, right? So, fly. Fly. For a bee, again, that's a very short word. You could just spell it. Or if you got stung by a bee, you can take that F and show the bug stinging you and then swatting it away. So, bee. If they stung you on your arm, you can do it on your arm. Bee. Got stung. Bee. Butterfly. One of the nicer insects, right? They don't sting us. That you're just going to loop your thumbs together. Keep the rest of your fingers real close, and you're just going to fly, like a butterfly. Butterfly. Dragonfly, same thing. We're just going to use two fingers instead of four. And you just fly, dragonfly. I've also seen some people use this, where you put your hands together and then fly. But it looks kind of close to rabbit, so that's a little iffy. Dragonfly. For a mosquito, we're very familiar with those down here in Corpus Christi, right? And for that, you're going to take two fists, hold one out further in front of you, one in between you, between your non-dominant fist and your nose, and this one's going to swirl. Mosquito. It does this because they have that really long nose, right? And they bite you and they get their nose down under your skin. They drink your blood. They're really mean. Mosquito. Mosquito. Spider. Might be a little divided on these ones, right? So for that, you're just going to place one palm over the other. Here are your eight legs and just crawl them forward. Spider. 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 For a worm, let your non-dominant palm, pretend like this is your dirt underground, and your worm is just going to move through the dirt. Just take an index finger and crawl it through the dirt. Worm. Worm. Caterpillar, very similar, except this time it's on top of the earth instead of in it, so it's going to go over your hand, maybe up your arm like a tree branch. Caterpillar. Maybe it's going down a leaf. Caterpillar. So those are just a couple of bugs that you may or may not like, but they are very common. So let's go ahead and move to some much bigger animals with our wild animals. There's not really any sign for wild other than to just spell wild. Feels a little funny going from L to D after doing those larger movements. W I WILD. Wild. And then just our sign, animals. Animals. So for our wolf, they have those long noses and they howl. So you're just going to take your hand and just kind of pull out like you're shaping their muzzle. Wolf. 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 For bear, we're just going to claw our hands and cross them, put them right at your shoulders, and you just kind of tap your shoulders with them. Bear. 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 For a lion, they have that nice full mane. So again, we're going to take our clawed hand and it's going to go up, over, and back down your hair. Lion. Lion. For tiger, they have those stripes. So take fours in both hands and just show the stripes right on your face. Tiger. 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 For a bat, you're going to take two X's, again, cross them at the wrist like we did for bear, and tap your shoulders. Bat. 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 For a fox, just take an F, place it right on the tip of your nose, and twist. Fox. 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 Just like that. For a deer, you're going to take two open hands, place your thumbs right at your temples, like antlers, and then bring them out. Deers have big antlers, right? Deer. 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 And then for a giraffe, you are going to show off that long neck. So take a C, start at your own neck, and then just keep going. We have really long necks, right? Giraffe. Giraffe. You might want to look up when you do it. Giraffe. Those are a couple of wild animals that we see on land. Now, how about some animals that we see in the water? So sea animals, sign for sea. First, it's a short word, so we can just spell it S-E-A. Or you can do the sign for C, which is to kind of show waves with your hands. C. C, animals. The first one we have is a dolphin. For that, there's two signs that are very common. First is to take a D for dolphin and kind of swim it in the water. You might put your non-dominant hand out here to be the surface of the water and have your dolphin jumping under the water. The other sign for dolphin is to take an R and open it by bringing that thumb up and make that same motion. So dolphin or dolphin, whichever one. For whale, you are going to make a Y like the tail of the whale. And then again, we have our surface of the ocean right up there. And the whale is going to go just up and down. You see that tail moving it through the water. Whale. You'll notice it moves in the opposite direction of dolphin. Dolphin, we went from fingertip in. And for whale, we're going from our elbow out. Whale. A shark, you're just going to take a B and place it on top of your head. Shark. Shark. If you want to show a shark moving through water, use your hand again as the surface of the water and move it forward. Like that. Shark. Octopus. We're going to make one hand the head, rest it on top of the other one. And these fingers are the tentacles of the octopus, and it's just going to swim upward. Octopus. Octopus. For a crab, they have those pinchy claws. So just take your fingers and make some pinchers of your own. You can do small ones like this, or you can do a small one and a big one, or two big ones. Crab. For a seahorse, there are a couple different versions. The first that you might see is a little bit literal to do sea, and then the sign for horse. Sea horse. The other thing, the one that I was taught, was to just take an index finger and kind of move it like a seahorse does through the water. Seahorse. Seahorse. If you do this, you might want to spell it out first and then show the sign. Seahorse. Shrimp. I've seen you take the pinky and just do the same motion as seahorse. Or take your index finger again and kind of move it. Shrimp kind of stay along the bottom. Sometimes they move along in the water a little bit differently, kind of crawling. So you can also do this for shrimp. So here, shrimp or shrimp. Then for jellyfish, you're just going to let your hand relax, let your fingers hang down like the arms and stingers of a jellyfish, and then just let it move. It's going to be kind of bubbly movement. Jellyfish. Jellyfish. All right. So those are a couple more animals that you might see, especially if you visit the zoo or aquarium. If I missed one of your favorite animals, which is highly possible because there is a whole lot out there, right? You can check out some of these online resources. There's some vocabulary websites. You can just type in the word and see a short, about 2 to 5 second video on how to do the sign. And also some YouTube channels that have a lot more signs of a lot more animals on them. And I use them as a resource when I need to look up certain categories of words. They're really awesome channels. You can also check out the Deaf and Hard of Hearing Center. Their website is deafhhcenter.org. And they do a whole lot for our deaf community here in town. They also offer some classes, which are still on pause right now. But when they reopen, they're definitely something that is worth checking out. In the meantime, though, you can get some resources from us here at the Corpus Christi Public Libraries. There's plenty of physical books that you can check out. And there's also resources on Hoopla and Access 360, our digital platforms, that you might want to look at as well. And don't forget to check us out on Facebook and YouTube. For more updates, go to cctexas.com/library to access our catalog, see a full list of all of our virtual programs, and check out the online browsing options with the new book alerts, author check, and the book newsletter. And I hope to see you guys again soon. Bye-bye!